If you enjoy the content here on Gemini Guitar, please consider visiting the download store, where there are a variety of products for sale, and you can even buy collections, which will save you quite a bit of money. Any support is greatly appreciated. Thanks. It is Corey from Gemini Guitar, and today we're back for some dream pop. So we're going to be focusing on basically two voicings here. The first one being a C major 7, and the next one will be an E minor 7, and also an E sus 2. So the first time through the progression, what I was doing was some picking ideas and things, alternate picking, a little bit of up picking, starting with a C major 7 chord. That's the basic voicing, and I'm going to be using the open first string with it, like this. So you'll notice sometimes I'm using consecutive upstrokes, and the reason for that is because I'm playing off the beat. So I'm starting out with the basic shape, picking through that. And then I'm going to use some consecutive upstrokes before returning further down this way and then going back up again. And then I'm going to change into the sus voicing. So it's not really a big change. All you do is just take the first finger and replace it to go down to the second string at fret 7. Take the middle off. Pick from the sixth string, and that's our basic voicing, omitting the fifth string. Note the two consecutive up strokes at the end there. And there's a variety of ways you can play through this. I'm not going to explain exactly what I was doing in the introduction because, as I said, there's different ways you can approach it. But the way I would do it initially would be something like this. Which I think if you look at it carefully is really very similar to what we were doing with the C major 7 voicing. There's also some embellishments going on. So I've got this thing that I'll do where I'll go at the end. So what I'm doing there is I'm picking the second string, hammering to the eighth fret, pulling back to the seventh fret on the second string, picking the third string, picking the fourth string and then the third string again. So it's down, up, down, up. And that just helps to create some variety in the sound. You can also extend the C major 7 voicing in a rather nifty way, actually. And what you do here is you've got this basic voicing over the four strings, remembering not to play the fifth string, so mute that. And what you do is you just get this little bit of your index finger here, and you just let it wrap across the seventh fret on string one as you're fretting these four notes. So you can see it's sort of turned diagonally there a bit. So when you play the string one, you should hear the B note. Might take a bit of practice, but it's well worth being able to do that. Very handy. Okay, so let's look at the other two basic voicings. We've got the C major 7 down here in the third position. And what I'm going to do then is play an E minor 7. That uses the low E string with a G triad. Because we've got that E note on the bottom, it's defining it, so it's an E minor 7. And we can just use a similar picking technique here. And again, you can extend the C major 7 voicing by creating the barred version. So you'd want your first finger barred from the first string to the fifth string. And you could do the same thing for the E minor 7 voicing, just bar the first finger over strings 1 and 2. I think in the intro there I might have used the A note as well, which is a nice little addition. I use the fourth finger there, so it's... Also at the end there, what I did, I took what we did just then and just put them into the next octave. So you just basically add 12 frets to everything here, end up in the 15th position for the C major 7. And then the E minor 7. Except for the A note. That changes it a bit. That's actually one of my favorite things to do. I'd say that's a bit of a signature in my own style. I used to do a lot of that in bands I'd play in. Obviously, if you've got a bass player, which most bands do, of course, that enables you then to go up into those higher realms without having to worry about doing anything on the lower strings. Even though these are the lower strings, are up in the higher octave. So quite helpful and, you know, just add some flavor and character to proceedings. So I hope you've enjoyed that lesson. And until the next one, bye for now.